Greetings my loyal minions and welcome back to another video. I hope you all are doing well and are having a wonderful week so far. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the notification bell. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns please feel free to leave a comment under any of my videos or hit me up on any of my social media accounts. If you want to donate to my channel I do have a Cash App, PayPal, and Venmo. Links are in the description below. You also have the choice of super chatting me whenever I'm live or you can leave a super thanks under any of my videos or live streams. Just keep in mind you are under no obligation to donate to my channel, but any bit would be most appreciated. Anyways, without further ado, let's get to. So, grab onto your neck braces and make sure they are firmly in place, grab a stiff drink, some popcorn, take a seat and hang onto your butts because we are going to be in for some more major whiplash.
Hey, what up you guys? It is Sassy Assassin here, back with another video. I hope you guys are all doing well and are having a wonderful week so far. And in today's video, I'm going to be reacting to an Amberlyn Reed related video titled What My Valentine Got Me for Valentine's Day and Why Don't People Want to Be in My Vlogs? Question mark. So, I totally forgot Valentine's Day was coming up. And that my birthday is coming up on the 16th. It's on Friday. And so, here's my plan for my channel right now. I have the rest of this week to finish all my coursework and everything for my job. Like, Friday is the last day, and then next week is gonna be, like, working while still in training, okay, being supervised. So my plan is that once I get all my coursework done, okay, I'm going to catch up on some of the foodie beauty videos and stuff like that because I just can't do that right now because I'll end up being here for like until like God knows what time filming each reaction, and so bear with me. I'm really trying hard to like compartmentalize the YouTube stuff, streaming, and work. So there you go. But anyways, without further ado, let's get to so. I have this on 1.5, so here we go.
Welcome to a new video. So you guys did see me wear this for my weigh-in. Today is Wednesday. My friends left Monday night, and I just rested the whole Tuesday. Your girl was pooped, and now it's Wednesday. I filmed my video. I've been productive. But you guys, try to guess what is in this heavy, huge box. I'll let you guys think about it while I tell you the story time. So there is someone in my life that I would say is special in that way. We're not in a relationship though, so calm down. But I have been friends with this person since September and we have become really good friends and like the whole time crushing on each other. We asked each other to be each other's Valentines. So that was like a cute thingy. So I'm gonna be referring to her as my Valentine because I'm not gonna say her name just out of respect. But she is one of my very best friends, but we like, I was gonna say low key like each other, but it's high key at this point. So I was on the phone with her and we were just talking about my Legos and I mentioned a Lego just like, you know, randomly a Lego that I'm interested in because we literally just talk about everything. And Legos is a very popular topic because I'm obsessed. I mentioned, yeah, there's like this Lego. It's like hundreds of dollars though. So I'm not gonna like get it anytime soon, but it's definitely gonna be the next one that I get for myself. That's like a bigger purchase. And we just like went on to the next conversation. And I think like an hour after we got off the phone, she messaged me and she was like, I have a question. And I was like, oh my God. Usually when someone just comes out like that and they're just like, I have a question or like, I have to talk to you. Like I immediately get anxiety. I'm just like, oh my God, what is it? She literally said, let me get you that Lego you want. And I was like, girl. So like after saying no,
why do I not believe her? My instinct is telling me this is a bunch of bullshit. Oh, I know why I don't believe her. Because she's a chronic liar. And she's lied about having friends visit her. Okay. So I just don't believe this. I don't believe this. Maybe this is her way of trying to get back at wifey. Like, I have a Valentine. Like, are you jealous? Bitch, ex-wifey doesn't give a shit. She's probably not even watching your videos.
After doing the whole, like, oh my god, but it's so expensive, I finally gave in and she got me, oh my god, I just can't even believe it. For Valentine's Day, she got me this Lego that I've been wanting. I just can't. Like, how sweet is that? But another small box came with that. So I'm gonna open it first. So I asked my Valentine, I was like, what do you want? Like, what do you want me to get you? Like, I feel so just like, I cannot believe it. Like, do I deserve this? She was like, no, if I think of something I want, I'll let you know. But I'm over here just like, I need to get you something. Like, are you joking? Oh my gosh, in that box was this limited edition. I guess it's like a Valentine's Day little Lego. It is so adorable. And it looks like this. Oh my God. You guys are gonna LOL, but the reason why I'm wearing this like little Valentine's Day outfit is because I knew this was arriving today, and I knew that actually today was gonna be the day that I was gonna ask her to be my Valentine. So it all just kind of like worked out perfectly, and that's exactly what I wanted because I wanted to have like a little girly pop outfit for that. I know that sounds silly, but okay. Are you guys ready?
My God, this whole girly pop shit is getting on my nerves. You're not a girly pop in any sense of the word, Amber. Just stop. Stop trying to make girly ha pop happen for you. It's not going to happen. I feel like Regina George, you know, in this moment. Like, seriously.
To see the Lego. Oh my god, I cannot believe this is real life right now. I'm so excited. This is heavy. Once you all see this Lego, a lot of you are gonna be very confused, but I love that. I'm just very quirky and confusing. So I am not like a Batman girly, like you're not gonna see me watch.
My God, I'm so quirky and confusing. I'm so quirky and interesting, you guys. Like, I legit have no life. My life consists of being holed up in my apartment, playing with Legos and diamond paintings and journals and wax melts. And I can't really cook for myself. I can't really walk anywhere. I most certainly can't drive, so I'm in no way independent mobily, but I'm such a quirky and interesting person that I have to basically lie, manipulate, gaslight, and then steal other people's content and ideas because I literally am like the most uncreative person on this planet. I'm sorry. It's been a rough day, okay? Today's class is rough, and you know what? I'm taking it out on Amber. I need a place to channel my rage.
Batman movies on my free time, but there are some pretty awesome Batman Legos. And the minute I saw the Batcave, I literally said I had to have it. Like, tell me that isn't freaking stunning! Like, it is the coolest looking thing ever, and I'm so excited to build that and then like have it.
Why even buy a Batman related Lego if you're not into it? Like, I don't claim to be part like so into the like Batman, like that the Marvel, DC, Marvel and stuff like that. But like I do like some Batman movies, like the Christopher Nolan verse Batman movies. Yes, I love them. Oh God, the older ones, with like Michelle Pfeiffer and stuff like that. I like those ones as well. There's even like Batman games. Oh God, I had a Batman game, but then I sold it. But like the Suicide Squad game that has recently come out looks pretty good too. And of course, it has Batman and Superman and stuff like that. So it's just like I don't claim to be like a hardcore fan, but like I do like Batman. Like, but she's not even into it, and she's like buying it. What for?
I don't know where I'm gonna put it, but she's gonna put it somewhere. Like, I am a
I bet you because she saw somebody online, on social media be like into like the whole Batman Legos and stuff like that, and she's like, and maybe it's trending somewhere, and she's like, oh, I gotta have it, because I've gotta be popular like everyone else. That kind of mentality is so like high school, middle school. Like, you can tell this girl peaked in high school. Like, seriously.
obsessed. And then the Batcave literally opens up, as you can see here. I am so excited. You guys have no idea. My Valentine.
Was gonna buy anything Lego related, it'd be anything Star Wars, like seriously. Or Harry Potter. Or even Lord of the Rings.
I am the person who got it for me. Like, literally, you know how grateful and appreciative I am and like shocked. I'm just very thankful for the connection that we have right now and like whatever's blossoming. Like, it's
oh
supposed to be.
God, here we go. Here we go, you guys. Here we go. I really think this is just to make ex-wifey jealous. And I will say this again, bitch, she does not even care. She has blocked you. She has removed you from her life. Like, she doesn't even respond to your texts. Like, it's over. Move on. You're not going to make her jealous. The thirst traps aren't going to work. Okay? And you know what's even more disturbing is some of those thirst traps are not just for wifey and or any potential like new lovers, but like for underage girls, 'cause she's very much into underage girls. And it's disgusting.
Really good. I love you. Like, you're amazing. Well, you guys, this happened. Yeah, it did. It broke. That makes me very sad. And that's gonna drive me crazy. Maybe.
You know what? Get some nail glue and just like glue it together. That happened to my sister once. Okay. When they used to wear falsies and she just glued it back together. They don't do falsies very much anymore though. They're more like both my sisters' nails are like impeccable. Like that's like one of their favorite like downtime activities is doing their nails.
Maybe I can like glue that piece on. Doubt it, but oh boy. Okay, guys, so I went to Five Below with my mom. Someone.
You doubt you could glue that piece on? Yes, you can. There's literal glue, nail glue, to glue. Oh my God. This woman is like legit stupid. Like, I just explained this to you. You could go on Amazon and just type in nail glue, and bing, bang, boom, it's there. My God. She like just like Fruity Beauty, these women are incapable of doing anything for themselves using their brain power whatsoever. If it requires just an ounce of like a smidgen of hard work, it's like nope, gone. Nope, not gonna happen.
To show you the things I got. It's a little haul moment. Okay, don't come at
Oh
me.
God,
I
here
literally
we
just got
go.
it even while FI blow. I was like, Mom, should I get this? But I feel like I would have regretted not getting it. So I want to put these on my couch. Oh, almost dropped her. So I want to put two
Oh
of
my
them.
God.
I
This is what she
honestly
spends
don't
her
have
money
anything
on,
else
you
to do.
guys.
It's weird and I love it. So we're gonna put it on my couch and see.
Instead of spending her money on something that could actually save her life, she's spending money on Legos and just stuff, you know, stuffed toys. Like, oh my gosh, Amber. You know that the recent video where she came on crying about her situation, how you know she's gonna die being a fat, death fat. You're happy this way. Because if you actually gave a shit about your situation, you wouldn't be spending so much money on this kind of crap. You would be like, you know what? You'd be proactive in your trying to recover and trying to better yourself. But it's clear as day that you are legit happy this way. And I can understand it to a certain extent. She makes good money. Okay, she lives in a nice place. She has somebody to take her around when she needs to go somewhere. Like, she doesn't have to really work. I mean, it's an easy life. You know what I mean? But you know the irony of the situation is I've never heard somebody l complain so much about their life, considering how easy her life is. And she could say, "Well, you don't know what goes on behind the scenes." Girl, we know. It doesn't take a scientist to understand, a psychologist to understand it. A gene what a genius or whatever. We know what goes on behind the scenes. A whole lot of nothing.
But I also got two more pillows. Just wait. So these are honestly so cute. I'm not sure how it's gonna go with my couch. But the thing is, I know that I can make it work. Tell me these aren't the cutest things you've ever seen. Oh my God. So I got two of them. They also had ones with cactuses on them, but these are where it's at. Like, I love the aesthetic of like this white color with like a pop of red with the cherries. I think it's so cute. And then, oh, dropping bags. And then another decor piece, which I thought was so cute, is this disco ball. I love the aesthetic of.
just spending her money on these tacky decorations. I'm sorry. This is ridiculous. And she wonders why she gets so much hate from people.
A disco ball? So I was like, okay, you're...
It's like during a time of like massive inflation when people are struggling to keep a roof over their heads, food in their bellies, some are struggling just to keep their homes and to pay their rent. This chick is living the easiest freaking life, not even working hard for the money that she has, and this is what she spends her money on. And she's a death fat that complains non-stop about how she's so unhappy with her life. This is an example of, I'm going to shop and you know, distract myself because there's a giant hole inside of me that nothing can fill. Not even food can fill that hole. You know what you could do, Amber? Get a job. An actual job. Something where you're going to benefit society. There are work from home jobs that she could do that will train her. Okay. I think mostly like, you know, low level like customer service job. Okay. That will literally train her to, you know, to service, you know, either, you know, you're in a company and you're just training, or you're in one of those places where you service clients, whatever, and you get paid for a contract, whatever. It's all work from home. She doesn't have to go anywhere. She's perfectly qualified to do it. Yeah, you know, it's not going to be a lot of money, and yeah, she doesn't need the money, but at least it's something to do. At least she's doing something to benefit somebody and to have something to do during the day. Like, or at least volunteer or something. Like, this is ridiculous. You call this content? You sitting here showing us what you got from Five Below, talking about your non-existent Valentine because you're too embarrassed to admit that you bought yourself those Legos because there's nobody on the other end trying to be your Valentine.
Pop needs one. I don't know if I'm gonna hang it or just like set it. We'll see. I got a new journal. Don't come for me. I journal a lot, folks.
Of course. Oh my god, she's so stupid. Of course you're gonna hang it. It's a disco ball. I can't.
Cherry. Over
and over. Another journal. You do not need all these journals. Just buy one, use it, and then buy another one when you fill the other one. I can't. This is just so ridiculous.
Last but not least, not that I needed these, there's just like a lot of different and weird types of candies at Five Below, and I wasn't gonna get any, but I saw boba milk tea.
A 500, over 500 pound death pet sitting here buying this candy. I'm sorry. This is ridiculous. You know, it's like, you know what? I had to go to urgent care recently, okay? And this urgent care has, you know, they offer, you know, snacks, okay, like, you know, so a chips, whatever, you know, whatever. They have water, coffee, tea, and it's a really nice place, and they also have a slushy machine, you know, because for kids and stuff like that. And I was like, they had an orange slushy, which is, when I was younger, an orange slushy used to be my favorite, like, so good. It's the same company, and I was like, oh my god, I want a slushie so freaking bad, okay? But I didn't do it, because I'm like, you know what, I've lost 22 pounds, okay? Like, I do not need that slushie. This is something you don't need, and you should not be having. If you were going to share it with somebody, that'd be different, you know? Like, put it in a candy bowl, I guess. And, you know, have, you know, like, you know what I mean? Like, and have it in the subsequent days, but she's probably going to eat that entire thing in one sitting.
Jelly bellies? So I was like,
When we buy stuff like this in my house, it's usually poured into a bowl and it's eaten by multiple people, like in the string of like even a month. I'm not even kidding. See, I mean, we have a little candy bowl in my living room, and it's what, whatever. And it's like a span of a month where something like a whole box of something like this would be eaten. So it's like, but she's the kind of person that's gonna have it in one sitting, just like Chantel. So I'm like, I'm not sitting here saying like, oh, she sh well, I did say she shouldn't buy it, but like, I'm not saying that anybody shouldn't buy it. I'm just saying, don't just have it in one sitting because that's a lot of sugar. But in Amber's case, in Chantel's case, shouldn't buy it because we all know it's gonna go. She's just gonna pour it down her gullet, their gullets basically. Exactly what's gonna happen.
I want to try them. Realistically, this isn't gonna make me gain weight if I try a few. So let's not get mad at the Jelly Bellies. We could do like a little taste test.
Not gonna make me gain weight, but later on I'm gonna basically chug that entire thing because I'm addicted to food.
A mango milk tea. A
This is basically her trigger foods, and she's just oh, I can't. I can't.
mango milk tea,
It's
mango milk tea,
infuriating.
strawberry milk tea, and Thai milk tea. They're all packaged individually. So the first one, because I know I'm gonna hate it. Let's do the matcha tea.
Yeah.
I'm not a matcha girly. All right.
Oh, I love
This is
matcha.
actually not bad. Wow. Okay. Let's do taro. Am I pronouncing that wrong? I'm not feeling that one. Ew. It very much reminds me of like the popcorn Jelly Belly, which I hate so much. Okay. So next one is the mango milk tea. I knew she was gonna be good. All right. Let's do the Thai one. Oh no. Oh, that tastes like rotted milk. That's a no for me. Last but not least, strawberry milk tea. I knew I was gonna like her. That's why I chose her last. Okay, so I wanted to show you guys one of my new favorite meals that I've
What
been
is
eating lately. Okay, so I
this?
get it from a Mediterranean place. This is seasoned beef. That's literally all it is. That was basically a kebab at one point. And then you get basmati rice, pita bread, and I like to get this hummus. So it's a trio of a spicy hummus, a basil pesto hummus, and just like an original.
You know what this hummus reminds me of? Like, I don't know if I guys told you this already, but like, it reminds me of the hummus that I get sometimes at this place where I get my CBD. It's a health food store. It sells, and it also. They make their own hummus. Like you can cut, like go, like actually order a homemade, like their homemade hummus, and it comes in a real, the kind of tub that we saw Chantel eat from the recently, and it lasts about a month. Okay, believe it or not, that shit can last for quite a while, and I get like this rosemary herb one, but that's still that's a lot of hummus. That's a lot of hummus. That I would see what you know what I wouldn't be eating all of that. Maybe because it's spread out, it seems like a lot, but I don't know. That seems like hummus for a multiple people. But I mean, I'm not gonna lie though, I do love hummus with some pita bread, some fruit, some veggies. Kind of like a little shuck, like little. Snack plate, whatever, but it's like I limit how much like hummus I have. I have a little contain, like a little bowl for stuff like that. So I and purposely I put stuff like that in that bowl so I don't eat too much because I know that if I just put it in a regular bowl, I'd be having like the whole thing.
And I try to just order this by itself, the spicy one, because that's the one that I eat. I don't really eat these two at all. But the spicy one slaps, and you get it with some pita, and it comes with a little extra pita. They do get a lot
Why did you buy then order three different hummuses?
of meat, though. I usually
Why not just get a small container? You don't even have that much pita. The ratios don't make sense.
finish two of those. And as you guys know, I'm not really a tomato girly, so I don't eat that. Okay, so I'm currently just chilling on my couch, but there is like a hot topic that people are talking about. People are thinking that I lied about having friends come visit me because they weren't in my videos, their voices weren't. And that's because I highly respect people's privacy and they didn't even want their voices in my video. So I had to respect that. And so whenever I would film something, it's because either they A, weren't talking. So we had a break in my filming because literally the
Amber, just stop trying to convince us that these friends are real. Because we all know they're not, okay? We didn't see anyone around you. We would have saw something, Amber. Something.
The whole time that we were here, it was just a lot of this. Like, so much laughter and just talking and just having a great time. And obviously I didn't film any of that because they just don't want to be in my videos. And I have to understand that. Like, in the past, I have filmed a lot of people and with some of the, like, the community that follows me, it makes it to where people don't want to be in my videos anymore. It has nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with, like, the way that a large group of people who watch my videos, the way that they, like, treat people in my videos. Like, it's just a lot of, like, doxing or just, like, really rude things are said and rumors, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm just gonna, like, respect people. People can think that I'm lying about having friends. People can think I'm lying about my weight. People can think I'm lying about whatever. I'm very much in an era where I just don't care anymore. Like, I've tried so hard to prove myself in the past regarding so many things, and it's like, sure, if there's like a rumor or a question or something that people are talking about, like, I will come on here, I'll talk about it, and then that's just gonna be the end of it.
Really? Really? Because we have yet to hear your explanation as to why you outright lied about FBI Frank. Really? You're lying right now. You don't address things, the important things. You're only going to address what you're ready to, you know, with a lie that you already have ready to go to cover up the other lie that you told. You cannot tell the truth to save your life. So just stop. You could sit there and say, I don't care. Like, you know, like, I'm above it. Like, whatever. No, Amber, no. See, while Chantel is more openly, you know, aggressive and obviously agitated and shows it, you're more inward. You're behind the scenes. You're very covert. Okay. You use sock accounts and stuff. We know this. Okay. So just stop. Just stop, Amber. We know you're lying about your weight. We know you're lying about the friends. Okay. And it is what it is. It is what it is, Amber, because the evidence just doesn't add up. Okay. So we're not buying what you're selling right now.
Like, I'm not going to sit here and just like rant and rave and vent and try to prove myself to a bunch of people who just don't want to hear what I have to say. So they create their own storyline from my life. Just something that I've dealt with on YouTube for a while now. And it's just like, I'm officially at like a stage in my life where I just like, don't care. Like, I'm unbothered, literally unbothered. Like I said, I'll mention something once or twice, but then that's the end of it. Like, you guys can enjoy whatever you need to do to fill your time. I'm just not going to be a part of it. So anyways, yeah, I just watched.
There are things that need to be addressed, Amber. FBI Frank needs to be addressed. Why you bullied that Rosie Faye girl needs to be addressed. There are many things. I mean, those are the two prime things that I can think of on the top of my head, but there are many things that are literally left unsaid that need to be addressed. And for you to sit here and say, oh, I'm just so unbothered now, bullshit. Bullshit. I don't believe it. Because on your other social media pages, it tells a very different story and it shows that you're still super bothered by what's being said about you.
A new episode of Jersey Shore. Super happy about that. I am behind on 1,000 Pound Sisters. I'm 2 episodes behind. I heard the last episode was like super freaking sad, so I don't know how I'm gonna be able to go into that. Okay guys, I'm about to put down my new pillows, but I just want to show you like what my living room looks like before that. This is just how she looks every day. Here are just some graphic novels. It's like my favorite graphic novel series. Well, one of them. It's Saga. So good. Over here is Twinkie's bed. She has that corner to herself. So yeah, this is before. You guys, I love the Papa Green. It does something for me, but I can't figure out what to do with the disco ball. So I was gonna take my Saga books off my coffee table and put this instead. Let me know what you guys think. Oh, that's a big no from me. That looks on the verge of pathetic. I do not like that. I might have to find a different spot for you. I just love it so much. See, this is cute. I love this, but now it's making me wanna like look on Amazon if I can find like bigger ones, because it just seems so small. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I know you'll be honest. Y'all, I just watched a halftime show. I do not watch football. Not really 100% my thing, but I did watch the halftime show because I have always been an Usher girly pop. Like, I love him so much. I literally grew up listening to his music, and
I'm an Usher girly pop, you guys. The girly pop thing, just stop. You're not a girly pop. Stop.
Great talent show. I did a dance to one of his songs with a really good friend of mine at the time. But that halftime show is by far the best halftime show I have ever seen. My millennial dream has come true. Like, that was incredible. I felt very transported back to that era of my life. I was grooving. And like the special, oh my God, the special guests, like Ludacris, Alicia Keys, y'all, that was awesome. If you haven't seen it, search it on YouTube. It was beautiful. It's totally random, but Usher is actually one of the biggest celebrities that I've actually seen in person. I was actually at a baseball game. God, I was probably 14. It was a baseball game in San Francisco, and he was actually there. It was a random moment. Did I go up to him? No. Did I want to? Maybe. So I am going to end this vlog. I do hope that you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.
Thank God that's over. What did we learn? Amberlynn is just continuing to lie. That's pretty much it. She's now having to make up fake friends, fake experiences. And now a fake Valentine, lying about who buying Legos when she's just buying it for herself. What a sad existence, honestly. What a sad existence. Because we all know, Amber, that behind the scenes, on your other social media, you are literally making thirst traps, trying to lure other women in, but all while also trying to make ex-wifey jealous. When, like I said, wifey wifey doesn't give two shits about what you've been doing. Okay? It's done and over with. But anyways, I'm gonna go. I hope you guys enjoy this video for what it's worth, and I will see you guys in the next one. Toodaloo, my loves.